Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Thursday, June 30th, 2011, end of the second quarter. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the price action we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. First, let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations, but we do provide real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. And we remind everyone that past trading performance does not predict future results. Do not trade money you cannot afford to lose. What you now see is a 4-hour chart without indicators for the Euro-USD currency pair, as that chart looked at 8 a.m. New York time on GFT's Dealbook 360 trading platform. And I've got this chart zoomed out to show price action since May 23rd. As I mentioned in both Monday's and Tuesday's New York session video reviews, the prospect of Greek Parliament passing a new austerity package and supportive comments last weekend by China Premier Wynne had been among the top factors supporting the Euro bull case this week. While Greece's parliament did in fact produce enough votes yesterday to pass that austerity package, and earlier today the Euro-USD established a new 14 trading day high. Today's Asian session high is represented by a horizontal orange line in the upper right hand portion of this chart, and you can see how that high from today's Asian session is above the June 14th and 22nd highs labeled 1 and 2 respectively. All of that plus a broader series of higher lows, which I've just circled in blue on the lower part of this chart, all of that makes the case for seeking opportunities to buy this currency pair today. Now, those of you who viewed Monday's and Tuesday's video reviews might recall that the long trade setups I discussed on those days involved, among other factors, a combination of role reversal and the Fibonacci retracement level. Those same two factors contributed yet again to another Euro long trade opportunity today. Before we take a closer look at today's price action, I should point out that another contributing factor to the case for a year long today was a trend line. Let me first zoom in on this chart for a closer look at that. The black uptrend support line formed by connecting Monday's low there, Tuesday's low there, and Wednesday's New York session low right there, that trend line seemed to be parked in the 1.4440 area at the open of today's New York session. With that in mind, let's switch now to a 15-minute chart for this pair. Here's a 15-minute chart as it looked at 8:30 a.m. New York time. Now, you can see the black trend line from the 4-hour chart crossing this chart, the trend line I just mentioned on the 4-hour chart. You should also see a horizontal orange line. That orange line represents yesterday's European trading day high at 1.4447. Now, since the euro broke above that level several hours ago, that same 1.4450 zone, which was resistance yesterday, might become support today. Also, if you draw a Fibonacci study of the move up from yesterday's low right here to today's early London session high right there, you learn that the 38.2% Fib retracement level of that move up, represented here by the horizontal bright red line, that 38.2% Fib sits at 1.4451. So there was certainly a case for longing the euro at or near 1.4450. And you can now see on the right-hand side of this chart, the euro rose some 40 pips from its low from the day. Now, do you pout? Do you cry if you miss that entry? You could do either, or you can make plans for a second chance entry, which I discussed at length in the live class today. Before I review that on a 3-minute chart, the second chance entry that is, note today's early Asian session lows near 1.4460. Talking about these lows right in here that I'm highlighting in blue. I'll refer to that level again soon. Here's a 3-minute chart without indicators as it looked at 10 a.m. New York time. The first chance entry in the 1.4450 area that I mentioned earlier, that's right in here. Now, I just mentioned the Asian session lows near 1.4460, and on the left-hand side of this chart, I'm highlighting with blue arrows today's European morning lows. So we have some evidence that the 1.4460 to 1.4465 area has been support at times today. That plus a 61.8% fib of the recent 40 pip rise, that fib level represented by the horizontal blue line. That was the case for a second chance entry somewhere in the 1.4460 to 1.4465 area, which I'm highlighting in blue right now. Now, if you took the long, your stop loss could be initially positioned 50 pips below your entry for catastrophic protection purposes, and your worst case exit strategy could be to close a trade for a modest loss if the euro makes a new low for the day. This is a 3-minute chart advanced forward in time by 2 hours. London close represented by the vertical red line on the right-hand side of the chart. If you stayed with the euro long, you got paid. Closing the trade just before London close netted you up to 60 pips depending on your entry. Again, entry down in here. Close the trade right in there. Now, I should also add there was a downtrend resistance line in the 1.4520 to 30 area near today's New York session highs, that trend line based on the May 4th and June 7th highs. Now, although that was a respectable profit earned on the most heavily traded currency pair, the euro was not today's star currency, nor was the US dollar. That award arguably belongs to the Swiss franc today. Here's a look at 15-minute charts for a couple of the Swiss franc pairs. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Thursday, June 30th.